Hello there, and welcome to Luigi Kid's Quest, an LPR-centric fan game made in RPG Maker. Let's start the game, shall we? I think a couple of characters on the screen we won't even really see. I wonder what it could be. Ah, of course, goombas. Why not? Now, to give you a little idea of what we're going to be in for with this game, Luigi Kid himself usually does videos on horror games and creepypasta games. Back from what I've seen of his channel, that's really almost all he does is just creepypasta and horror games. Now there's really not much to interact with this house besides the toilet, the PlayStation which throws on the Resident Evil song that you can clearly hear right now, I think this computer, and about one more item is left. I wonder where that item is. Ah, it must be in the kitchen. Yep. I don't cry every time, man. I do not cry every time. So with that, let's go. Right, there really isn't much out here, but I see a pipe, and that means we must go in it. Yes. Ooh, special reward. Let's see what it is. Now, I really don't think his real backyard has a hedge maze with his name spelled out in the background. But, whatever. One more coin left, and there it is. Right, what's our special reward? Oh yeah, that. Huh. Alright. Maybe there's something up here. Now that looked to be a Slender Man, so... Huh. The weird thing is, the outside of the house has a second floor, but the inside doesn't. Oh well. Let's go to Luigi Kid Town. Now we have a couple areas we can go here. The cemetery, which we can't go to right now. And, Oh yeah, I forgot. We gotta go to the forest too. Bet we don't want to wander in alone. Now, admittedly, the jump scares in this game aren't really scary at all. In fact, the game I played before this was a maze game where you had to run from Peach to PewDiePie. That actually startled me a couple times because when the pictures pop out, you really didn't know where to expect them. Which I guess was bad for this game because this game really isn't that scary. Even though you think a guy who's channels based off games that have jump scares would have a pretty good game with jump scares, or pretty good jump scares for that matter. Doesn't apparently seem to be the case though. So basically, one of these goombas out here has the key. We gotta get it to get to the pub, to get into the pub and save the other mushrooms. Maybe this guy has it. So this guy's let slip loose where the toads are, and that another Goomba has the key. Now you may be wondering why I'm not walking into these houses, because you actually can't. There's only one place you can technically walk into, and that's the pub, which we actually can't get into right now. You know, one thing this game really has missed is a chance for a great pun with the Goombas. Instead of just calling him like the Goomba boss, they should just call him like Goombas and be good to go. Really missed a chance for that pun. Eh, whatever. Let's talk to the Goombas. Right, so the Goombas basically said the key is in the cemetery. Let's go grab it. Hopefully it sure isn't a trap waiting for us. it's Grayscale Yoshi. What you got for me, friend? One thing I will give this game is the fact that, most creepypasta games usually end in a .exe type thing, even though that's every freaking program on a Windows computer. But I like how this game actually tries to give a reason behind it, sort of. It makes turning to .exe sort of like a story. And not just something that happened for no reason. So this cemetery does have a lot of graves. You can read them all, but there's really nothing special about them. Just a bunch of names with dates. This grave is probably the only one with any real flavor text to it. So, welcome to the hardest part of this game. You're gonna find out why it's hard fairly soon. Of course, it was a trap, man. Would it be any different, honestly? Alright, so here's the minigame for this section here. We have to collect all the crystals while avoiding the Koopa Troopas. Or the Hammer Bros. If the Hammer Bros touch you, it's game over. That's really it. And they will track on you, whether you're moving or not. And we just got EXEified. Now these guys are a real pain in the ass. Especially since you can't move while you're collecting a crystal with the screen flashing the way it is. But they can still get you. So if you're collecting a crystal and they touch you while you're in a position where you can't move, it's game over. So you have to plan your route carefully and try to avoid these guys. And there we go, we saved Yoshi. That's right, those are task manager crystals. Huh. Yeah, let's read the instructions. Now, after the haberdashery that was the Hammerbro maze, this maze is a lot easier. In fact, those bats can't even hurt you. The only things you have to be worried about here is the skeletons. That's it. And they move slow. So the premise here is that the first key we got opens up a chest. That chest gets us another key to open up another chest. And just keep doing that until you get the golden key or the master key to open up the big giant golden chest somewhere in the maze. Really all there is to this. Now this area does have a jump scare, but that's only if you get touched by the skeletons. All that really happens there is screen goes black and well you get a black screen with a picture of a colored skeleton skull off to the right side of the screen, and that's really it. So it's a jump scare you can mix, you'd be expecting even if you got caught by a skeleton. You won't be seeing that here because these skeletons are very easy to avoid outside of probably just one of them. Now, I really don't know what Yoshi's purpose here is, since we can most likely just do this as Luigi Kid himself, and this game doesn't have any standard RPG Maker battles. In fact, this game can be considered an action RPG, if anything, but there are no battles in this game. We got the yellow key, and now we gotta find the yellow chest. Now, another cool thing is, I don't know if we see it here or not, it's somewhere around the center of our maze. Oh, there it is. You can actually see the cavern floor spell out Luigi Kid. I wonder if we're gonna get back up and actually see it. Because I think we have to go by it anyway to get to, I think, the next chest here. It's a, right over there is the one that's hard to avoid, but we can go around it. And there is the purple chest. Now that brown skeleton right over there is the one that got me before. As I tried to come up, it came at me and game overed me, essentially. That black one's going to be impossible to get by, so you have to be patient and work your way around these two guys here. They don't even track towards a player, they're just basically set to random, I guess, and just walk around their little area. Which is honestly better than the Hammer Bros setup where they would chase you all over the place. Imagine how hard this maze would be if these guys tracked on us and chased us all over. It would add more tension, that is for sure. Now this area might look like it has a lot of places you can interact with. You know, like that statue, the fountains, all the gold, there was a coffin earlier and a couple beds. You can see the bed right there. But no, you can't interact with those. They're just there. And there we go, we got the pup key. Now, it is possible to try to leave this place without the pup key because exits to our right. But Luigi Kid will say no, he needs the key and we can't leave. Alright, so let's go into the pub and save our friends. And no, there's nothing to interact with in here either. I was really hoping we could read those notes, but, well. Alright, we got the cell key, and that cell key will open up all the cells in this room. Oh, crap. Well. Yeah, it looks like I'm stuck. Let's see if we can get out of this. Let's see if we get out of this. Come on, man. There we go. Yay. Now, I wonder if this town is just populated by these few toads. And if so, how the hell did, what, 3 to 4 goombas manage to capture every citizen? Now, I do not know who Master Max 888 is. I'm going to guess that maybe he's Luigi Kid's arch rival or something. Because that'd be pretty cool, I suppose. But now that the Goombas are hired by Master Max 888. But yeah, now we're having a party. Because we saved everybody. Well, that was a nice adventure. Yeah, perhaps we should play some oop, what's this? Now, I just noticed something about Slenderman's sprite. He looks like he has his hands. Yeah, he's got his hands set up on his hips like the an old Superman pose. Huh. Ooh, and apparently the Goombas have been trying to take over Slenderman's forest. I guess he's teaming up with us as a chance to get some sweet, sweet revenge. Alright, here's the thing. They didn't trap you in the Labyrinth of Death. You chose to go in there yourself, son. Well, the labyrinth had an exit you could have walked out of, but no, you decided to stay and get the key yourself. So it really wasn't trapped in there per se. Alright, so the special power is we're turning into Slender Luigi. Alright, so this phase of the game is fairly easy. All we gotta do is well, interact with the other Goombas. Come on. There we go, like that. I wonder what they're even doing here running all over the place. It looks like they've been trying to dig a hole. Or various souls. Maybe they're searching for some treasure. Oh well. And look at that, we still have those two guys off to the left that we have not seen in this game yet. But the ones in the center and the two off to the right we have seen. I don't know where the Kingdom Hearts song in this play is out, or where the Mario Party song is. Hell, half these things I don't think I've even seen in this game. Huh. Well, that was Luigi Kid's quest. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time.